This video explains the unique composite eye feature with the Medmont E300 corneal topographer. This function allows us to take multiple images across the corneal surface to build a broader perspective on the eye shape, elevation, power, and wavefront error. Start by clicking on the patient name, then click on Capture Corneal Topography. The next step is to take a normal fixation capture. In other words, have the patient look down the axis of the instrument, centering their fixation on the central placebo ring. Once you have a 95% or better capture, click Save and then Clear Images. Now we'll go on and take our second image. In this case, we're going to have our patient look 3 rings to 5 rings toward the nose. This is a right eye. You'll notice how the patient is fixating in toward the nose, which is going to push the rings toward the temporal side. We want to image the placebo reflection when it's hitting the limbus on every aspect of the cornea. In this case, we've now pushed the rings to the temporal side. Once we've saved that image, we can go on and take our next image. We're going to now have the patient look 3 to 5 rings temporal and push the placebo reflection to the nasal aspect. When we have a 99% or better, we'll click Save, and then again, click Clear Images, and start over and take a fresh image. Now we're on our fourth image. We're going to have the patient look superior 3 to 5 rings. And push that placebo reflection to the inferior cornea and sclera. Once we have a 95% or better image, then we'll click Save Images and Clear and take our last image. Having the patient look down is the trickiest of the bunch because we need to pull the lid back. In order to move the cone close enough to take an image, the finger has to be out of the way, and that can be slightly tricky to do. As long as the eye isn't extremely deep set, you should be able to push the cone close enough to take that image with the patient looking down. In this case, we're able to push the placebo reflection to the superior cornea. You see some eyelash shadows here. Possibly we could do a better job of pulling the eyelid back and pulling those eyelash shadows away from the placebo reflection. However, it can be tricky to get in quick enough before the tear film breaks up. By pulling the lid back, we're hindering normal blink rate and normal tear flow across the corneal surface. So that last capture will be the trickiest of the bunch, but it is possible to do on most eyes. Once you have your images, you individually click on each one of them or click on up to 4 images at the same time. Effectively, what needs to happen is Medmont needs to convert the placebo reflection to a colorized image before a composite eye can be created. Here's our image with the patient looking down the axis of the instrument. In other words, a normal fixation on the visual axis. The second image is with the patient looking 3 to 5 rings toward the nose, pushing the placebo reflection toward the temporal side. The third image is having the patient looking temporal, pushing the placebo toward the nasal aspect, 3 to 5 rings looking temporal. The next image is having the patient looking 3 to 5 rings superior, pushing the placebo reflection inferior. Last image, having the patient look inferior, pulling the lid back and pushing the placebo reflection superior. Once you have the 5 images or more, you can take images on the 8 principal axes of the eye, nasal, temporal, inferior, superior, superior nasal, inferior temporal, and superior temporal. You can take more than 5 images if you desire to make sure that you're getting 100% of the placebo hitting 100% of the cornea. When you've got your images highlighted, you can go up to Analysis and Composite Eye. Once we hit Composite Eye, the Medmont software will analyze each one of those images for error to determine if any one or more than one should be retaken. Once I click Composite Eye, you'll notice the software has analyzed all the images and determined that the image taken at 12:57 minutes 25 seconds in the PM has an average fitting error of 5 microns. In other words, this image should be retaken prior to doing a composite eye. We should eliminate the third image, 12:57:25, retake that fixation, and then calculate the composite eye with 5 or more quality images. Once your composite eye has been created, now you can see that the image capture is on virtually 100% of the corneal surface. There's a small amount of information missing from the superior temporal aspect. We should therefore have the patient take one more fixation where we're looking inferior nasal to push the placebo superior temporal and make sure the rings are capturing this area of the corneal surface. When comparing the composite eye area of capture to a normal fixation, a normal capture with our Medmont, notice how we're getting a large area of information on the corneal surface. The Medmont has one of the largest capture areas of placebo ring topographers. However, there is some cornea that's missing. And that's where the composite eye feature is very beneficial to us. We're able to calculate the eye surface across virtually 100% of the cornea. This is very important to us when we use the Medmont contact lens fitting module to build a large diameter GP lens that may be hitting the peripheral cornea. This may be helpful for the scleral lens fitting module when we're trying to determine and predict the shape of the eye past the visible iris diameter so we can predict the appropriate scleral lens fitting parameters. And this will also be helpful for the freestyle lens when we are trying to build a larger diameter lens and we need to understand the shape and elevation of the eye across 100% of the cornea.